series of mathematics class 10. Dear students, in the previous video we have learned what is meant by GST and how the GST is calculated in the tax returns. In this video we are going to solve some examples based on GST. So here we have the example from practice set 4.1. So example is Mrs. of Real Paint sold 2 tins of luster paint and taxable value of each tin is 2,800 rupees. If the rate of GST is 28%, then find the amount of CGST and SGST charged in the tax returns. Okay, so in this example, we are given with the taxable amount of 1 luster tin and that is 2,800. Okay, the GST rate is 28%. So let's write down what things are given. So rate of luster paint is 2,800 rupees. How many tins are there? 2. So quantity 2. Then taxable amount. Taxable amount means on which amount we are going to pay the GST. Okay, that is the taxable amount. So taxable amount is 2,800 multiplied by 2. As the 2 tins are there, that's why multiplied by 2. And we get the 5,600 rupees. Okay. Rate of GST is 28%. So we have to find out the CGST and SGST. So the rate of CGST is equal to the rate of SGST. These both rates are equal and these rates are half of the rate of GST. And the rate of GST is 28%. So half of 28%, that is 14%. So let's find out the amount of CGST is equal to the rate of CGST multiplied by taxable amount. The rate of CGST 14%. Taxable amount is 5,600. So here these two zero will cancel and 14 multiplied by 56 will get 784 rupees. Okay. So in this way, the amount of CGST is 784 rupees and amount of SGST, as these both are equal, that's why the amount of SGST is also rupees 784. So in the tax invoice, CGST and SGST amount will be 784 rupees respectively. Let's see the next example, that's question number 5. So here the total value with GST. So whenever we get in a question total value, it means the GST is already added in. Okay. So the total value of a remote control toy car is 1,770 rupees. Rate of GST is 18% on toys. Find the taxable value, CGST and SGST for this toy car. Dear student, here we asked to find out the taxable value. It means what is the original cost of a car? Because here what value is given, that is with the GST. Okay? Then we asked to find out the CGST and SGST. So let's solve this. So here let the taxable value of the car be H rupees. Okay? Now here the GST on toys is 18%. So the rate of GST is 18% means when taxable value is 100 rupees, then the total value is by adding the GST, the value will be 118 rupees. So dear student, here the ratio of total value with the taxable value is constant. Okay, so as this ratio is constant, we can use this to find out the value of car. So here total value of toy car is given 1770 rupees. Okay, so here 100 rupees car we are getting at 118 rupees with the GST. Same way X rupees car, we are getting 1,770 rupees. Okay, so let's take the cross multiplication. 180 into X is equal to 1,770 multiplied by 100. And if you want to find out the value of X, if that X is only, it is multiplied, it will divide. And after solving this, we will get the value of X as 1,500. And what is the X? That is the taxable value of a toy car. So taxable value of toy car is 1,500. Okay, now again what we have to find out? CGST and SGST. So let's first find out the GST on this 1,500. So GST at 18% on rupees 1,500 is equal to 18 upon 100 multiplied by 1,500. So here also this 0 will cancel. 18 into 15 will get it as 270 rupees. Okay, this is the GST. Okay, and we are knowing that amount of CGST is equal to amount of SGST, and these are equal to the half of the amount of GST. So here amount of GST we got 270, so its half will be 135. So here CGST rupees 135, SGST rupees 135, and the taxable value of car is 1,500 rupees. Okay. Now dear student, let's see the next question. Question number 7. The question is, Prasad purchased a washing machine from Maharashtra Electronic Goods. The discount of 5% was given on the printed price of 40,000 rupees. Rate of GST charge was 28%. Find the purchase price of washing machine. Also, find the amount of CGST and SGST shown in the tax invoice. So let's see the solution for this question. So first we'll write down what things are given in this question. Printed price of washing machine, that is 40,000 rupees. Discount is given 5%. Rate of GST is 28%. We are knowing that on the luxurious item, the GST rate is 28%. Okay. So what we have to find out? Purchase price. It means after giving a discount of 5% and charging the GST 28%, what is the purchase value of the washing machine? Then amount of CGST, amount of SGST. Okay, so let's first find out the discount. So discount is equal to 5% of 40,000. So here we'll calculate this. So this zero is cut. So 5 into 400 will get 2,000 rupees as the discount. Dear students, now here the GST on the amount will be 40,000 minus 2,000. Okay, so here we get 38,000. After removing this discount, what value will get? On that only we have to charge the GST. That is only called the taxable value. So taxable value of washing machine is equal to 40,000 minus 2,000, that is 38,000 rupees. Okay, now we'll charge on this 28% GST. So let's calculate that. GST at 28% on 38,000 is equal to 28 upon 100 multiplied by 38,000. And after calculating this, we'll get 10,640 as the GST. Okay? Now, as we have to find out the amount of CGST and SGST. So let's find out that. Amount of CGST is equal to amount of SGST, and these values are equal to the half of amount of GST. So here half of GST already we got, that is 10,640. Its half will be 5,320 rupees. Okay, so these are the amount of CGST and SGST. Now we have to find out the purchase price of the washing machine. So in that, taxable value plus amount of GST. And what was the taxable value? That is 38,000. After removing this discount, what value got? That is only the taxable value. That is 38,000 plus GST 10,640. After adding this, we'll get the purchase price of washing machine as 48,640 rupees. Okay, so let's write down all the answers together. Purchase price of washing machine 48,640 rupees. Amount of CGST 5,320 rupees, and amount of SGST is rupees 5,320 rupees. I hope it's clear, okay, students. We are going to learn a very important topic of this chapter, that is GST in trading exchange. So let's first learn what is meant by a trading exchange. So here in a trading exchange, generally four people are involved. Okay, so these are manufacturer, wholesaler, or we can say distributor, then retailer and consumer. Okay, so we are the consumer. So if you want to purchase any goods, so we cannot go directly to the factory. Okay, so obviously what we are doing, we are purchasing that object or that goods from the nearby shop or the market, from the market. Okay, so that shopkeeper, you can call him as a retailer. Shopkeeper is a retailer. Now here, that shopkeeper or retailer also does not bring the things from directly the factory. So he also purchase that from the wholesaler. Okay, then this wholesaler brings the goods from the manufacturer or from the factory. Now let's learn with an example how the GST is charged and paid to the government at every stage of this trading, that is GST in trading chain. Suppose manufacturer of a watch has sold one watch for 200 rupees including profit to the wholesaler. Wholesaler sold that watch for 300 rupees to the retailer. Retailer sold it to the customer for 400 rupees. Rate of GST charge at every stage is 12%. Then how each trader pays GST and takes his input tax credit at every stage of transaction is shown in the following chart. So let's observe and study it. Here, three financial transactions took place till the watch from manufacturer reaches to the customer. How the taxes are charged, collected and paid to the central government and state government at each stage is shown below. The statement of taxes paid is given in the table thereafter. Here, all the three financial transactions took place in one state. Therefore, three tax invoices were generated as shown. Each tax invoice shows the brief computation of GST. The first tax invoice is of manufacturer, that is B2B. Trading between GST iron holders is known as business to business, and in short we can write it as B2B. When the trading between GST iron holders and consumer, then it is known as business to consumer. In short we can write it as B2C. So here second tax invoice is of wholesaler, that is B2B, and the third tax invoice is of retailer for the consumer, that's why it is B2C.
So dear student,
In this trading chain, there are traders like manufacturer, wholesaler and retailer. Let's see how they paid the GST to the government. So, manufacturer sold the watch to the wholesaler at 200 rupees, wholesaler to the retailer at 300 rupees and retailer to the customer at 400 rupees. The GST rate on the watch is 12%. Okay, so these persons charge 12% at every stage. So here, manufacturer sold the watch to the wholesaler at 200. Okay, so 12% GST of 200. So it will be 24 rupees. So here, manufacturer collected 24 rupees as the GST from wholesaler. And all that 24 rupees paid to the government by this manufacturer. Okay, now this wholesaler sold the watch to the retailer at 300 rupees. Okay, so he will also charge the 12% GST. So 12% of 300 is 36 rupees. Okay, so here wholesaler collected 36 rupees from the retailer as a GST, but he will not give all that 36 rupees to the government. Okay? Because here, already this wholesaler had paid the 24 rupees GST to the wholesaler. So, this wholesaler will take out his amount, what he paid to the manufacturer. Okay? So, here he collected 36 from the retailer. So, 36 minus he paid 24 rupees. So he will subtract that amount what he paid to the manufacturer. So 36 minus 24, that is 12 rupees. So this wholesaler will pay only 12 rupees to the government as a GST. Okay? Now, here, retailer sold the watch to the customer at 400 rupees. So he will also charge the 12% GST. So here, if we calculate the 12% of 400, so it will be 48 rupees. Okay? So here also, this retailer will not pay this 48 rupees GST to the government. Okay? Retailer collect the 48 rupees as the GST from the customer. But he will not pay all that 48 rupees to the government. So here, what he will do? So, as he already paid 36 rupees to the wholesaler, this retailer paid 36 rupees to the wholesaler. So, he will also try to deduct that amount, okay, from this collected GST. So, 48 minus this 36, that is 12. So, this retailer will pay only 12 rupees as the GST, okay. And for the customer, the watch which was the cost of 400, now it will be 400 plus this 48 as the GST. So for the customer, the watch will be of 448 rupees. Okay? Now let's calculate how much GST is paid to the government by these traders. So here, manufacturer paid 24 rupees, wholesaler paid 12 rupees and retailer also paid 12 rupees. 24 plus 12 plus 12 and together it is 48, right? So total GST is 48 rupees, okay, which was paid by these traders. And now you can see here, the customer paid GST, how much? 48. So in this transaction, the total GST is paid by the customer, but it is indirect. So this is the indirect GST. Okay? So in this way, the GST is calculated in every stage of this trading. Okay? Now here, this wholesaler the manufacturer. How much? 24 rupees. So this 24 rupees he paid as a GST at the time of purchase. So when a trader paid GST at the time of purchasing, that is called input tax. A trader pays GST at the time of purchasing is called input tax. Now for the wholesaler, what is the input tax? That is 24 rupees. Okay? Now, when the trader collects the GST at the time of sale. Now wholesaler sold the watch to the retailer. Okay? And he collects 36 rupees as the GST. So this 36 GST at the time of sale, that is called output tax. Output tax is 36 rupees, right? But the actual amount paid by this wholesaler as the GST to the government is 12 rupees. It means here, this wholesaler, what he did, from this output tax, 36 minus input tax, that is 24. So, GST payable for this wholesaler is 12 rupees. So, here, each trader is taking the credit what he paid to the at the time of purchasing. Okay, so at the time of purchasing, what GST is paid, that is called input tax, and that tax is deducting from the output tax. That is called this deduction amount. This deduction amount is called ITC. That is input tax credit. Okay? So, in this way, we can say that GST payable for any trader is equal to output tax minus ITC. ITC, that is what amount is deducting from the output tax, that is the ITC or input tax credit, that is the input tax credit. Okay, now here for the retailer, what will be the GST payable for the retailer? So here for the retailer, his input is 36. For the retailer, input is 36 rupees. And his output tax at the time of sale, how much he collected? That is 14. So his output tax is 48 rupees. So, GST payable by the retailer is output tax minus ITC. ITC, input tax credit. So, 48 minus 36, that is GST payable for the retailer is 12 rupees. And here, the all taxes, whatever is paid by this trader, all together, it is paid by the customer. Okay? Because everything is collected from the customer. So here, customer is paying the indirect GST. So I hope it's clear to you. So dear students, in this video, we learn how to find out the GST on given items. Also, we learn a very important topic, that is GST in a trading chain. I hope the concept is clear.